Ya estamos aquí, no te preocupes, si necesitas video, no te vas. Si no alcanzas nada. Ok, pero bueno, no, todavía no, 7:30.
Check, 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 check. 1, 2, 1, 2, mic check. Test. 1, 2, 1, 2. Mic check. Test. 1, 2, 1, 2, mic check. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Okay. ¿Sí? Todo sudado. ¿Sí? Ok, perfecto. Un saludito a todos.
Sure.
Yep.
Yeah. Ingredients are keeping us.
Get it.
Mira todos los colores menos el que uno quiere. El que va por el rainbow.
¿Ya vaciaste todo? ¿Está bien?
¿Ya sirve?
Yo más si quieres el eslogan en la cara.
Está bien.
Thank you.
Ya le conté acá 40 seconds.
Estás aburrido
con tal. Sí, así me. Ah, 30, faltan 10. Pero yo creo que ese es el momento que sí descansaste.
Sí, el último.
Exacto. Yo sí me despierto como a las 8, 7, y lo voy a dejar una hora más, 2 horas. Y ese es el tiempo que siento que voy a dormir. Es más, ese es el único rato que sueño. En otro tiempo no nunca sueño, pero en ese ratito, esa hora y media, sí sueño conseguido así de repente.
Mike,
A ver. Bien para no dormir. Ya, 40 seconds. 30. Exacto. No, 30. 35. No, 35. 5 minutes.
Everybody ready? So let me start with James Brennand turned himself in about an hour ago. We walked a warrant for him. I had met with homicide during the week on several different occasions, and When we got to the point where we needed to be, I instructed that a warrant be walked for him for two counts of aggravated assault by a public official, which is a felony one. So he is in custody right now, and this is still an open case, so there are certain things that I'm not going to say. If you ask a question that involves anything that I can't talk about, I'll tell you that I can't talk about it. But right now, the message is that he is in custody. We worked on this for several days to get to this point where we could submit a warrant to a judge for a signature, and that's where we are right now.
Chief, why these two charges?
Pardon?
Why these two charges?
Why what?
Why these two specific charges?
There's an ag assault charge for each of the people that were in the car. So it's an aggravated assault on the driver, for the driver, and an aggravated assault for the passenger.
We've heard from some activists today that they would like to see attempted murder charges. Was that considered?
You know, that's not the conclusion that we came with right now. That'll be up to the DA if he decides to change that. But our case led us down the path of aggravated assault on a public official.
Can you explain why?
By a public official.
Can you explain why it didn't lead you to the path of attempted murder and y'all settled? Or
I'm sorry,
can you explain why it didn't lead you to the path of attempted murder and y'all chose aggravated assault?
No, I mean, this case was worked up by the detectives in homicide. They look at every fact. They check every box that they need to check to be able to make the case that they're making, and the case that they came up with was aggravated assault by a public official.
Chief, we heard some concerns from protesters outside about how long the investigation into this case could take. Do we have a more definite timeline on how long it could take?
Well, the main part of the investigation is the part that leads up to an arrest or a warrant being submitted. We've completed that, but the case has not gone to the DA yet. The case has not been presented to the grand jury yet. We've been in discussion with the district attorney's office. There may be some more information that they need before they take the case to the grand jury. I don't want to speak for the DA, but there are things that that still need to be done in this investigation before we can say it's completed.
Do we have any timeline on how long that could take?
No. I mean, look, our goal right now is to get him in custody, and that's been accomplished.
Could there be more charges, Chief?
No. Not as far as we can tell at this time. If there were, we would have charged him already. But right now, the case that we worked up were the two ag assault cases. So, and again, we were confident that we had what we need to make those cases.
What led the department to deciding to bring up charges against the officer?
Why
did the department decide to bring up these charges?
Why?
Yes.
Because, starting off with the shooting itself, it was unjustified, both administratively and criminally. So since there was a criminal component to this, that's why we investigated it as a criminal offense.
Or wasn't the officer working with a field training officer, being that he was only 7 months with the department?
He was certified to patrol alone. And let me add this, that the day after the shooting, we met upstairs, the command staff and the training academy staff, along with the tactical instructors, and we talked about our policy, we talked about our training, and we were confident that our policies and our training when it came to this type of incident are sound. So
he was certified. What's the difference? When does somebody become certified, and when do they need to have that field training officer with them?
Well, they go through a field training officer, they go through what we call the rides. And it's 15 weeks that they're with a field training officer, and they're certified at the end of that 15 weeks.
So he passed his course, but then just failed to follow his training?
Look, I said this before, that someone questioned our training and our policies, and my response was that this was a failure for one individual police officer. It had nothing to do with our policies. Policies did not allow that. Our training does not teach that. So this was a fail for one particular police officer, and here we are as a result of that fail.
Sheriff, it's public the picture with the officer James Brennand. He's arrested.
Would you say that again?
The picture with the image with the
picture?
Officer. Yeah.
Well, you'll have to get that from the county.
Chief, did the officer have a history of any of this type of behavior?
No, not that I'm aware of, and not that I've been informed of. So my answer would be no.
And have you been in contact with the family of Erik Cantu at all?
We have.
How is he doing? Do you know?
My understanding right now is that he is still in critical but stable condition.
Can you give us an idea of that conversation, Chief, with the family?
No, Henry, I'm not going to go there with that. The conversation between the family and the department will stay between the family and the department unless they want to reveal what was discussed.
Chief, does this incident change how you're going to maybe modify trainings for your officers in the future?
No, I just said that our training and our policies are sound. We met with our tactical training officers the day after the shooting to discuss that. And actually the entire academy staff, the captain and the sergeant as well. So, and the tactical training officer. So the answer to that question is no.
One last question.
Have you spoken to the officer at all?
Let me go here. Go ahead.
Yeah, do you expect to change the charges again on his health condition, because we know he's on life support? If he wasn't to make it, do you expect
if he does not make it, then the charges will change.
Is there a bond?
Thank you very much.
Right, one more.
Have you spoken to the officer? Does he show any remorse, or has he said anything to you guys?
I have not spoken with him prior or subsequent to the shooting, and nor do I intend to. So thank you all very much. Appreciate it.
Did we have a bond?
That's going to be set by the mayor.
Yeah,
if I give you a little more background, if you want, the difference between ag assault and attempted murder really comes down to the mental state, the culpability, but essentially they're the same charge. It's the same penalty group charge, both first-degree felonies. So it becomes, however you charge it, it becomes sort of what the DA feels that's most appropriate that they can prove. And typically, again, we've been in contact with the district attorney's office, and that was something that was discussed. So it doesn't, the penalty group doesn't really, it's the same penalty.
Mm-hmm. What are the penalties?
Well, it's a first-degree felony.
Yeah.
So a minute, 5 to 99 years.
To 5 to 99.
Yeah.
So you made Google.
There you go, man.
Bye, Doc.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you, guys. I know y'all waited a little bit, but we appreciate you guys. Thank you.
You don't start doing that.
Yeah, y'all know. Y'all.